Oh, I did that, yeah. Right.
Oh, cold.
Oh, God as well.
Good love it. I told you.
Yeah. Oh!
You mean you're horrible?
No.
Absolutely horrible.
Are you absolutely freezing?
Not anymore, but I was.
Hello there, this is Andy McNabb.
Hiya.
What I want to say first is, well done. I've got to tell you, there's 19-year-old soldiers who have gone through something very similar and haven't as lasted as long. You know, it's not an everyday experience that you've gone through.
And as you've seen, it's not so much about the physical. We always tend to think about interrogations as being physical.
It's all about the mental strain of an interrogation.
Okay, well, obviously, there's the reason that you're here now is that there is a winner and there is a loser. And the winning housemate is Amy.
I'm not surprised by that.
And Anthony, what I'm going to say to you, mate, is that
nobody's lost. Nobody's lost at all, because it's a learning experience, mate.
So it's to you, Amy. Of course, you did last longer in interrogation. You didn't give out the PIN number, and now's the time to use it. So if you can go to the safe.
Amy, what you need to press is start 00 and then your PIN code.
And then turn the lever. And take out your wad.
Oh my God.
That's all yours.
That's £5,000. I think it's going to be party time when you get out there. Now, Amy, as you also know, you're immune from the next public vote.
Oh, no.
Yes.
What you've got to do now is select another housemate to be immune from the next round of nominations.
I think after this traumatic day, if anybody deserves to be immune, then it's Anthony, to be quite frank.
I think that's a good choice. But now it's over to you now, Anthony. You've got a tricky decision to make now, mate.
What's his decision?
He's going to nominate someone.
Nominate someone.
Wow.
What I want from you
is the one housemate to automatically face the public vote next week.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, Anthony, listen, mate, you know, everybody will understand, you know, how hard this decision is to make, but it's just, you know, it's falling on your shoulders, mate. You know, it's big shoulders and a deep breath time.
One, this is the one reason I didn't want to, like, lose this task, and I got told that if I cooperated, then we'd all be immune from the nomination.
Come on, who's it going to be, mate? We can't wait all day.
Just because, like, I feel bad because he went through again, like, he went through it last night, but just because, like, he must have, like, loads of, like, female...
Oh, I know this is. I know this is.
Keep him in, but because I've got the going experience going for last night, I'll have to say Victor, but nothing against you, mate, seriously.
Oh, man. Anthony, no one's going to be annoyed with you.
It's all right.
Listen.
You didn't have a choice.
It's fine.
No, exactly.
He's crying.
Listen, Anthony, don't worry about it, mate. Everybody will understand the decision you've made, but both of you, fantastic job. Both done well on many different levels, both physically and mentally.
Thank you.
If you're ready, both of you can now leave the diary room. Just well done. A really good effort. Thank you.
Chase, is that it?
Please don't be sad. That's what I would have done.
That's what the dream is.
You alright?
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Alright, Amy.
That was well done.
Good girl.
Come here.
You're late, mate.
Oh, fucking hell.
You're fucking awesome, buddy.
Well done, man.
You're awesome.
Ugh. 2:55 p.m. Callista and Anthony are in the bathroom.
Are you gonna be okay? You're not gonna have a breakdown, are you?
No.
It was the hardest bit, having to nominate someone. No one's gonna be angry though, everyone understands.
Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
I'm proud of you though, I'm glad you showed that you could do it.
I don't like them trying to akin it to people that actually have to go through, like, war interrogations and stuff.
How do you think Victor feels now?
I think he expected it.
To be honest.
I expected it. Go on.
I think he made a really good decision. I was thinking in my head that that's what I'd have done.
Andy McNabb is in the Big Brother hijack booth. He's been hijacking the house for 7 hours and 56 minutes.
This is Andy McNabb. Just want to say congratulations to Amy and Anthony. Let's give them a round of applause. Woo!
Well done, guys.
Thank you.
You know, I don't know about you lot, but I've had a good day anyway. Yeah. I've had a really good time.
I bet you have.
Yeah, it's been great. So what I want to do is give you all a parting gift, a special air service type parting gift. So tomorrow's rations are going to be basic rations. It's going to be brown rice, crack loo paper and anything else we can find that's a bit squirmy to go around in the pot. So enjoy the rest of the time there. See ya.
What a beast.
What a dickhead.
What a beast. He's a beast of a man.
3:16 p.m. Jeremy, Amelia, Nathan and Amy are in the bedroom. Victor and Callista are in the bathroom. John and Latoya are at the dining table.
Nathan, vegan girl.
Do you actually like him? Or is it just super there?
He reminds me, like, of people at home. Like, I get along with him really well. It's because we know the same people, so...
So you were aware of him before you came in here? You were, weren't you?
Yeah. I was going to dance for him ages ago, but he cancelled the show and I went on tour. I think he's a nice guy and everything, but I don't date, like, singers or artists, though. I just know what they're like. When you're in that field, it's just, I don't know, do you know what I mean?
He seems pretty nice, though.
He's a nice guy, but he's just, I don't know, I think he's for me.
Close your eyes.
You're just sitting here smiling, you can't even see through the glass.
Yes, you can.
Yeah, but he's not looking, he wouldn't think that I'm looking.
I know you're looking and I know what's wrong.
Oh, my God.
Right, that's...
I'm joking, John.
Anthony is in the diary room.
Big Brother just wanted to check to see how you're feeling.
I was a bit down. I've obviously had to, like, nominate someone for eviction. That was the one thing I didn't want to do. Good task, though. It was a really good task. And, like, I was actually quite enjoyable. And I was just like, I don't like people lying. Obviously, that was, like, part of the interrogation, and he had to do it, but I just don't like when people lie. Like, the last couple of days have been pretty, like, rubbish, to be fair. Like, Jade got evicted last night, which I was a bit gutted about, because she's cool. I got on with her really well. I could have a laugh and a joke with her, and it just brought out the best of me, I think. But it's always ups and downs, isn't there? So I'm trying to get on with it.
You, what you talk, yeah? Okay, but when I talk, you listen, you go get her.
Nine:12 p.m. Some of the housemates are in the living area.
Please, sir, I want some more.
More? You want more?
What's funny about that?
It's from Oliver.
It's like the oldest joke ever.
It's not a joke, it's from Oliver Twist.
I know, but why is everyone laughing at it?
Why were you laughing at your rubbish jokes earlier? Actually, you rubbish jokes for the last 8 days.
Fuck you! Fuck you! You think you can make fun of me like that? I'm gonna take you out of this house and beat you like a little girl. You know that?
Really? Oh, is that what you're gonna do, Victor?
Yeah.
Hey, mate, got some kung fu, Shizer.
I'm gonna break your legs and put you in a racing car and expect you to drive off a cliff.
LaToya